Hi, Bob Kraft here of tennisministry.org, a series on the pro tennis players. Today we're talking about Juan Martin del Porto. And I am not so close to him as a player, but I have been around. I noticed, you know, this year is 2011, 5 years ago, 4 years ago, he was always making the sign of the cross when he would play. And he was doing very well. He was winning tournaments. He was at the peak of his game. And I was looking for opportunities to go speak to him about it. Again, the Spanish-speaking players, I've got some contacts with some of the entourage members through the number of years, trainers, physical trainers, coaches, and they like me and they support me, and I've helped them. And I don't know how much of an influence that has sometimes with the player. Maybe the entourage member tells the player about me or whatever. Or maybe the entourage player themselves speak about their fate to that player. But Juan Martin is somebody who had a great run. And everybody's saying he's playing very well. He, you know, went to the finals of Grand Slams. And I was looking to meet up with him in Tokyo, at the tournament in Tokyo. Well, he went in, and it's an easy place to talk to players because it's very informal and the players are very relaxed and nobody's really trying to talk to them. And he went in that tournament and he lost in the first round. It was a surprise. He lost to somebody he shouldn't have lost to. And he's out, and I think he was the number one seed. So he's out the door and I don't get a chance to talk to him. So then I was looking at other tournaments, okay, Cincinnati, you know, looking for ways to meet up with him, because I would see him do on TV the sign of the cross when every time he played matches, even to this moment. And then he had injuries. He had some physical injuries and he's been off the tour for a year or two, so there wasn't any contact. I'm almost sure he knows I'm a pastor. We haven't had communication, really, per se, and I've tried to initiate that, but it was really the circumstances. He'd lose in tournaments, some other tournaments, he'd be playing, and all of a sudden he'd be out quickly. I couldn't follow up, and that's just the way it is. Sometimes you have to trust that God is in control of these circumstances, and you know, you don't have to make everything happen. There's a reason why I don't get a chance to talk to him. I don't really know what it is, but it's not from a lack of trying. Now he's back, he's playing again. I saw on TV a few days ago, he's still making the sign of the cross when he plays. And you know, we just encourage that. I think that out of all the players in my 40 years on the game, there's only two players that I've seen who've actually done that, maybe three. Okay, one is Djokovic, the other is Del Porto, and the other is Bagdatis. And I've spoken to all three of them, except Del Porto. I've said hello. We couldn't really call that speaking to him. But, you know, let's pray for these guys, okay? That's a really great thing because it really sends a message to the world through the press that this is something important to that player. It doesn't have to be that you have to believe in it, or that this player is trying to force you to believe in it. Not at all. It's just something that's important to that player. Well, why is it important? That's the question that needs to be framed. You know, why does that player do that? Why is that important? I don't have the answer to that. Only the player can talk about that because it's a personal thing to them, not to me. I can say why it's important to me, but that's the situation there, and lift him up in prayer.